Hey everyone, this week it is Mental Health Awareness Week, and I just want to recap an event that I hosted today, which I was absolutely honored that I was invited to come out and share my energy. I was at the WAVE Youth event, and I absolutely love doing youth events just because it's an opportunity for me to kind of like lose that so-called corporate kind of attitude and really get back to my roots of you know, being a child and having an imagination and not having any kind of serious cares in the world. And today, that's what I got from these guys. There was about 300 kids. The energy was fantastic. Their excitement was unreal. And I was really able to kind of just pause for a moment and see what it is to be a youth today. So with that said, with Mental Health Awareness Week, we touched on bullying and anxiety and mental health within, you know, our communities and in our schools. And it just made me realize I want to touch base on it a little bit more. Growing up as I would say as a teenager, it's difficult being an adult. Don't get me wrong. Let me start from the beginning. It is difficult being a grown up. Okay, we got bills, we have responsibilities. We have midlife crises, all these kind of things, but nothing compares to growing up as a child in 2016. Social media, peer pressure, academic stress, all those type of things are so many things that kids are battling today. And being at this event, and seeing how excited these kids were by social media and you know, their selfies and hearing some of the stories of some of the kids I spoke about, I was like, man, I'm kind of glad I'm not a teenager growing up in today's day and age, because these pressures are real. And we talk about these pressures, but I don't think we really break it down in a way that a youth could take that feedback and dissect it and be like, okay, this is what I need to do. We're in a competitive time. And, you know, we have social media for many purposes. Unfortunately, there's a lot of people who use social media for the bad. Now, I know people hear this talk all the time, but we need to talk about it. We need to keep talking about it. There's people who are using social media to bring each other down, that they're using social media to you know, tweet things that, you know, this person did this, or this person's not good at that, or this person's whatever. Like, we have a powerful tool that we could be using for so much good, but we're choosing to use it for a popularity contest. We're using it to brag, we're using it to bash and bring down, and we're not using it to empower, uplift, educate, and connect. Those are the things that we should really be using these tools for: Snapchat, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all of those things. And, you know, when we had a break, an intermission at the show, I had these girls come up to me and I asked them what grade they're in. They're like, we're in grade 9. Can we follow you on Instagram? And I was like, yeah, sure. And I was happy that I have a social presence, that I don't have to worry that if children that young begin following me, that I'm gonna be putting out content out there that's either gonna be teaching them to, you know, abuse their self-esteem or not celebrate themselves or, you know, follow the latest trends. I'm glad that I don't use my platforms for that. And I had no problem telling these girls, yep, this is my Snapchat, this is my Twitter, this is my everything. Be connected, because I wanna help you see things in a different way on social media. I want you to come on and not be wowed by my outfit, but be wowed by my content. I want you to follow my posts, follow my tweets, and see how I talk about upliftment and having the confidence to slay. I don't slay my look, I slay my opportunities, from speaking on stage to doing workshops to whatever I do, I slay. And that's what I want them to know. I want them to know that I slay with style and grace, and you don't have to sell yourself in a way that, you know, maybe down the line you're gonna regret it, but that from everything you do, from beginning to end, you're proud of what you're putting out there. And I'm not that old, you know, I'm only 28, and I had these kids looking at me like I was some huge celebrity figure. And that is a lot. That's a lot of responsibility to have people of that age looking to you. And I don't even want to use the word idolizing. It's a very, they're just looking at you. You know, they're just looking at you and trying to model you. And so with us being adults on social media, whether it's Snapchat and all these things, I think we really should be putting out content out there that younger people who are watching could look up to, and they could use that content for the good, and it could hopefully inspire them to change some of their habits. And one time I did a talk at Chinkusi Secondary School, so if any of my Ching girls are watching, hello. I did a talk at Ching School, and I was brave enough to tell them about some of my Facebook posts and how Facebook has this new feature. It's not really new, but you know, it's out there, that it tells you on this day, and it will show you posts from like 3 years ago. And I'm reading some of the things I was putting out there a couple years ago, and I'm like, that's not me today. You know, thank God I have grown up. And so now I think about what I'm putting out there, and I don't want it to make people doubt themselves or make people feel that they have to be pressured to be a certain way and act a certain way and do these things. I don't want them to be pressured. I want them to feel okay that whatever route that they're taking, you know, with work and with, you know, confidence and the right people, you could get where you gotta get. And with Mental Health Awareness Week, you know, I really wish we could just talk in a way that people will understand, and understand that you don't have to conform to what other people are putting out there. You know what I mean? Like, I know I'm saying I want people to look to me for certain things, but I want them to look to me just for encouragement or support, not that you have to model what I'm doing. So I thank the youth that I met today. You know, I'm still trying to process this whole day, and I'm sure my video is like jumping here, there, and everywhere. But I'm really just trying to make sense of this day, because it was so amazing. It was a beautiful day. The energy was fantastic. If you have not gone through my Twitter feed and seen some of the videos and the pictures and the tweets and the shout out requests and all these things, it was just a good day. It was a really good day. So for any youth who are watching this video on this day of this week of Mental Health Awareness Week, know that people like myself and Luis and everyone who was participating in Wave Day, we are here for you. We are here to help you, to listen to you, because we encourage people to talk, but if we're not listening, what's the point of them talking? So we are here for you. And like I said, shout out to all the youth leaders out there. It is incredible to see what some of these kids are doing for the community. When I was that age, let me tell you something, I was rushing home to come watch Pokemon, okay? That's what I was doing. I was not, you know, helping sponsor a family to Canada. I wasn't putting together campaigns and initiatives to end bullying and to build self-esteem. I wasn't doing any of that. So shout out to the youth who are doing something good and impactful. You have no idea how you are in our community, in the work you're doing and who it's helping. You know what, not everyone gets accolades, and a lot of people get caught up in that, oh, I'm doing things, but I'm not getting the shout out and the recognition for it. Your time may not be now, but it will come, and we salute you for everything that you guys are doing for the youth who put together fantastic campaigns in their school for Mental Health Awareness Week. Thank you, because that's the population that needs to know we really are there for them. A lot of these kids don't know how to communicate their pain or their emotions or their frustrations, and they just need to know that there's people out there who care and are willing to listen. So that is my recap of today. It was a fantastic day at Wave 2016. I would love to be a part of Wave 2017. I don't know if they use the same host twice, but if they do, I'm right here, because I had such a good day and I had such a good time. And I thank all of you for bringing your energy to Wave. It was a fantastic day. Again, I know I keep saying it, but I can't get it out it was just so good. So I'm signing off. I really hope you got a message from this video. If you did, be sure to share it, comment. All my information is below, and I will catch you guys at another event on another week. Stay good.